There's now a division in Cobb County in the district attorney's office, and they started this several years ago because of the high frequency of these incidents, and they now actually have an elder fraud division within the Cobb County District Attorney's Office and within the Cobb County Sheriff's Office and Cobb County Police Department. And you can absolutely go to any one of those agencies and report it if you have any reason to suspect anybody's being physically
abused.
That's
so good. And people need to know. And they need to advertise that. People know. Because I do think when you hear about some woman who's abusing, like, all these people in her basement, people had to see something.
That's right. And people need to be able to go and report that. And you can do so, of course, anonymously through the through any of those agencies.
Good.
But likewise, as people become aware of scams and people become aware of, things that are, if someone's taking advantage of an elderly person, they need to take those to those relevant agencies. Obviously, they'd rather you not, if you get the email telling you you won the lottery in Nigeria, you probably don't need to report that to them. They're already aware that that's
right.
Circulating. But these things pop up. Tax time is a very frequent one. There's these IRS scam calls that go out to the elderly, and they always have to put out a warning about that. There's a jury one that goes around. Just so everybody knows, you will never, ever, ever get an email from the Cobb County Courthouse about jury duty. It will always come in a formal mail document called a summons. The jury administrator is never going to blast out emails to anyone, so don't ever fall for there's kind of a jury scam out there that tells people they've been fined. Yeah, it tells them they've been fined for not showing up for jury duty and that they're subject to penalties and they need to send in money for a penalty.